Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Lilkendey. Today I'm with Senator George Maziarz, the sponsor of legislation that changed the law in New York and allowed Nik Wallenda to walk across Niagara Falls into Canada. How are you, Senator?
Good. On a wire, not on a bridge. On a wire.
On a wire. You know,
the whole world knows now.
Yeah. I'm really delighted that you believed in Nik Wallenda the way you did. You supported him through this whole thing.
I did. It was a leap of faith on both our parts, I think. But he came to me over 2 years ago and said he wanted to walk on a wire across the Niagara Gorge in front of Niagara Falls, over Niagara Falls. And it has been banned since the late 1800s. And we started the process going, and it culminated in a beautiful weekend and a great walk and a whole lot of attention, worldwide attention for the city of Niagara Falls. Those are pictures of the crew that's just before the walk. That's Nik talking. That's probably about 2 hours before the walk there, and his family was there. We had a little camping atmosphere, and there's the wire. The anchor was just next to that spool of wire.
And his uncle is a NASA engineer, right? And NASA's, he helped develop
right,
that?
His uncle is a NASA engineer who actually does all the technical stuff as far as the wire is concerned, the tension, the torque, and all that stuff that I don't understand. But he obviously did a great job.
Right.
They had to have a particular weights on the wire at certain points so that the wire would not twist. And they figured all that out. And they were able to get the wire up. A helicopter actually had to take it across the gorge.
Right, and he was there on the other side waiting for him.
Yes, his uncle was on the other side.
It was completely mind-blowing. And I want to just go right to that right now, okay, where he's going across the finish line and he races across the finish line.
It took him about 26 minutes. There he is.
My camera's a little shaky. I was, you know, no tripod and there it was so thrilling.
He's running. And he gets off. You took this?
Yeah, that was from the vantage point.
And we had set up with the Canadian Customs that a Border Patrol agent would be there, and he had his passport in his pocket. And some people actually took offense to the fact that Canadian Customs asked him for his passport, but it was all planned. It was all, and the customs agent, if you live on the border like I do and other people do, you know, they generally ask you for identification. And then they always say, what's the purpose of your visit? And the customs agent asked him for identification. He said, I have my passport, gave it to him, and he said, what's the purpose of your visit? And his answer was to tell children around the world that their dreams can come true. You know, so that was all planned. Yeah. And some people took offense that the Canadians were saying, you know, you had to go through this official, you know, but it was great. It was fantastic.
It's definitely cool, and he has inspired people. I still have a charge from watching that whole thing.
It was a long time coming, and that day was just filled. I was out there in the park at 6 o'clock in the morning, and I have to give kudos to the State Department of Transportation and the City of Niagara Falls personnel. The city looked beautiful. It was, you know, there were flowers planted all over the place. There were people downtown milling around. There were things to do, you know, there were jugglers and clowns and
everyone wanted to be a part of the circus performance. Right. We have a picture of you with Senator Gallivan, and I just want to ask you, you know, what were you guys saying to each other as you were watching this?
Well, you know, we were there watching, and you know, I think I was chirping as I said to Nik Wallenda just before he got on the wire. I said, Nik, there are two careers on this wire tonight. because I was so intricately tied to you know, getting him the permission to do this. And a lot of people were involved, but it all started in my office, and he, you know, we were just concerned that he was going to make it, concerned that there was going to be a problem, you know, but there wasn't. I heard just a couple of days ago there was not one arrest made for unruly behavior on either the U.S. or the Canadian side. You think over 100,000 people were there watching this, and not one disorderly conduct, not one person got out of line. But Nik made it across safely, and I've been saying it from day one that the publicity, that the positive impact this would have on the city of Niagara Falls, you know, the day after, you know, the worldwide coverage, the front page of probably every newspaper around the world had a picture of Nik Wallenda, you know, in the middle of that wire. with Niagara Falls as a backdrop. And he walked where he has seen Niagara Falls from a vantage point that no other human being ever has.
Yeah. And I just mean, out there alone right. on that wire, it's right. just...
And I have seen a replay of the ABC feed, which was a three-hour special. And at 26 minutes, we were walking across the wire. He was talking to his dad, and he was praying. I would have been praying, too. Mm-hmm. But I just think it was just very impressive. Mm-hmm. When he got up on the wire, he met with his family, and I was there with them. And something unusual happened. He told me it never happened before. His son, who was about 6 years old, started to cry. And you could see it affected him. Because he talked a little bit with his son, and then he and I walked over to the lift where he was going to actually be lifted up to the wire, and he said, you know, my son has never cried before one of my acts. I mean, we do this as a family all the time. His son walks on the wire. Mm-hmm. And he said that, he was just, the son was scared by all the media attention, all the television cameras and all that stuff, and he was thinking, you know, we do this all the time, why is this one so special, you know? But he's 6 years old, so right. he didn't quite understand it. And I guess some of the kids in school were asking him about it, you know, and saying, well, what if he falls, you know, and everything, and in his mind, you know, his father could never fall, you know. But so he got up on the wire and we had kind of a private conversation, just the two of us, and it was amazing when he got up on the lift, and I mean, he just got on the wire and started walking. I mean, it wasn't a second thought.
He made it look so effortless. He was going so quickly. He's so strong, yeah. and mentally and physically, it was really a beautiful thing to see, and I think that everyone should see it. It's so inspiring.
It is. A couple of times, I think when you asked what Senator Galvin and I were doing there, a couple of times that balancing pole looked like it was sort of like waving yeah. a little bit, and we were, you know, saying, well, I hope that's not a bad sign or anything, but.
And he's so grounded, you
yeah,
know, a,
he is.
A very
he is.
Charming person to just see, and a family-oriented man, and it's really refreshing.
The only person who could talk to him while he was on the wire. I mean, ABC could ask him questions, but that would be overridden by his dad, who was his safety engineer. His dad he and his dad would talk all the time while he was out there on the wire.
Yeah, it's great to be able to work every day with people that you trust, your family, your friends.
Saturday night, we had kind of a victory dinner, if you will, with the crew. And some of the people who were very instrumental, Roger Trevino, John Bartlemy, Henry Wotazek, Rick Winner, all those people really helped out a lot. And we had a dinner at a restaurant in Niagara Falls, USA. And, obviously the word spread around the restaurant that Nik Wallenda was there. People were just lined
what
up.
What restaurant was it?
It was the Como restaurant on Pine Avenue. I should give them a shout out, too. They did an excellent job, Dominic and Louie. And their staff just really prepared it very well. As well, the food is always great there, but people, obviously, when the word went around the restaurant that Nik Wallenda was there in the banquet room, there was a wedding going on in another banquet room.
Oh,
the
wow.
bride and groom came over and had their picture taken with Nik Wallenda, and a little kids wanted the autographs and their shirts signed and everything, and then I think the word spread out onto the street that Nik Wallenda was there, so people started coming in, and he didn't never refused a person. Would stop eating, between courses, and just go out and took pictures and signed autographs for people. Now we've got some challenges going forward. Niagara Falls, New York is a depressed city. They want to change the economy. There were a lot of naysayers and people who didn't believe in. Nick, he sees the U.S. side is one that needs a lot of help. He wants to be a part of it if he can. He's already signed, or actually, I shouldn't say he signed. I really don't know much about the business end of this stuff, but he's met with a publisher. Major publishing companies contacted him about writing a book. He's inextricably tied to Niagara Falls now for the rest of his life. Mm-hmm. I think there's probably positives there on both sides, for Niagara Falls and for Nik Wallenda.
Yeah, drumming up support. as we talked about the last time you were here, you are a special correspondent for Channel 7. How did that go? What did you talk about?
That went very well. We started out early in the day. I think we were on AM Buffalo. That's Linda Pellegrino and myself. And you can see the bumper stickers that they were giving out. It said, watch history be made in Niagara Falls, New York. And that went very well. You know, it's you can see it was a great day. That's Steve Clark. Steve was with Clark Crane and Rigging in Lockport, New York, a local company that Nick hired to do the rigging of the cable and the crane work and everything. And Steve and his crew and his family were all there, and they just did an excellent job. That's Keith Radford from Channel 7. I think that's probably the 5 o'clock set that we were doing. You can see the brink of the falls right there over Keith's shoulder, and you can see the wire set up there too. So actually where Nick walked, he walked in the upper rapids and then right over the brink of the falls. And that's...
We kind of lost him in the mist there for like a few seconds. Right. I was like, where is he? You know, and then he reappeared. Right. I was glad he was wearing red.
Right. Yeah.
It was a perfect color.
Yeah, it was. It was a perfect color. Yeah. And you know, as I said, he has seen Niagara Falls from a vantage point that nobody, no other living human being ever has. And even the previous wire walkers, those from the 1800s, walked further down the river. They walked away from the falls, away from the mist. Mm-hmm. And that's what makes this walk so unique. And, you know, my goal now is to sit down, you know, with Nick and his crew and get him to establish some sort of a family entertainment venue. That's the lift that actually lifted him up to the wire where he got on and did the walk.
Pretty rainbow.
Yes.
I love it. You can always catch a rainbow there.
It was a great day. You know, everything was just perfect. And and the city, you know, not everyone could be out in the state park. And by the way, I want to give kudos to the state parks police, the state police, the local police and fire department. They were excellent. The Niagara Falls Fire Department was there as Nick was suiting up, and they wanted to see exactly how the harness was going to fit and everything. I presume that they were doing that not out of curiosity, but because they thought that if they would have to rescue him, they wanted to see how he put the harness on so that they could take it off quickly. So it was, I mean, they were thinking ahead, and that was just very professional on their part. I thought it was a real good moment. But everything shined. I mean, the park staff, you know, the fact that, you know, Governor Cuomo decided, made the final decision not to charge to get into the state park. So it was a free event. Mm-hmm. on the USA side. I know on the Canadian side, they made a lot of money by charging people for the best seats in the house. Uh-huh. But we didn't do that. It was open, it was free. And I think the tickets went in about, I don't know, I heard like 2 minutes on the internet.
You also, excitement was everywhere, even outside of the park. And you made it down to Old Falls Street.
I did.
Where there were vendors and a lot of money being made there, too.
Vendors, a lot of probably food that wasn't so good for your health, but but it was a good day in Niagara Falls. You know, we don't see many days like this, but this was a good day.
Yeah, it's an incredible sensation to feel so positive, and you really could see it on everyone's faces.
Yes, it really was.
Yeah, I wonder how much money was made over the weekend. It'll be interesting.
I don't know. I think, you know, from Nik Wallenda's vantage point, I think the financial payoff will probably come into the future. You know, now I'm sure that he's going to get a lot more opportunities that probably pay him pretty good money. This one was very expensive for him. I know that. Toward the end there, it was very precarious, and that's really where I got to give Rick Winter from Richardson Management kudos. He came in at the end and lined up some last-minute sponsors that allowed the event to actually take place.
Yeah, you know, I'm not a fanatical person, but this was something that I was really
obsessed
with.
You'll talk about this to your grandchildren.
Yes, and, you know, people will be coming to Niagara Falls.
You saw history being made.
Live, yeah. Thanks so much for being with us and talking to us about it.
Okay.
Thanks for watching Your Voice with Senator George Maziarz. For any other information, you can log on to the Senator's website, maziarz.nysenate.gov.